I solved 500 modules this one. Okay. I only focused only on the subjects which were a bit volatile. Focus on the volatile subjects, focus on the subjects you find difficult, and focus on the subjects where you feel that you are sort of, you know, somewhat lacking in the content. And so focus on them and bookmark the questions which you find difficult or which you had no clue about. I usually do is that finish one subject, take one subject, don't grapple with a lot of subjects at a time. Just focus your mind on one particular subject, finish it system by system or chapter by chapter, whichever is comfortable. I mean, whichever is comfortable with you, you know, everyone has his or her own, you know, style. So break it into small blocks and do the MCQs, concern MCQs related to that. So I was a QBank Plan B user. So as you know, pick up the subjects, especially the initials, like the, I mean, the foundation subjects and all, because I mean, those had completely vanished from my memory. So I used to, you know, pick up one subject, the notes or whatever I had, just read them quickly. But I did, I mean, it's not possible to, you know, integrate everything in like in one particular session. It's not possible, you know, to just pick up one topic and then read the physiology behind it, the pharmacology, the other clinical aspects. It's very difficult, you know, to sort of accumulate it at this. I mean, definitely we have good, very good sources, but it's very difficult, you know, to completely do that. I don't personally find that very viable for me per se. I would rather say I just focus on the subject which is at hand, okay, and okay. Then so after that move forward. Keep 1 hour for subject you're doing, okay. Keep 1 hour for the subject, and I mean in that do approximately 40 to 50 MCQs, maybe 40 to 50 MCQs, okay. And quality MCQs use that clinical if possible, okay. And apart from that, next half hour do a bunch of mixed back questions from the custom module. Okay, that's all. Keep it on moderate and do a bunch of mixed back questions, maybe 20 to 30. That's all. You don't need to do much. So I solved 500 modules this once. Okay, I only focused only on the subjects which were a bit volatile. Focus on the volatile subjects, focus on the subjects you find difficult, and focus on the subjects where you feel that you are sort of, you know, somewhat lacking in the content. And so focus on them and bookmark the questions which you find difficult or which you had no clue about. And I would say just dedicate one day, maybe half an hour or so, maybe, I mean, in one day, in one particular day, maybe half an hour, 1 hour to those bookmark MCQs. Okay, so I'll be very blunt here again. The custom modules, like, at times you will feel like crying when you're attending the custom modules, because you get very beautiful scores in the custom modules. Okay, like personally, I used to get how much, like 2 out of 10 maybe, or like for example 8 out of 25. Like, it was like so depressing at first, because the questions are very, very standard, I would say. Like, so when you're attempting a custom module, I would say keep it as 25 questions, go for 25 questions at a time. Okay, don't overdo it. Select the difficulty as moderate. Always keep it as moderate. Don't go for easy or don't go for hard either. Okay, that's not to be done. Keep it at moderate. Click on the clinical or say past year papers. Click on the tab which is there on the custom module space. Okay, and then practice 25 questions at a go. I mean, you might use a timer, you might not. That depends on you. Whether, like, if you do have a problem in managing time, definitely go for a timer. Otherwise, if you don't have a problem in managing time, go for the regular feature, which is just, you know, question answer type. So do that. And find out the percentage. Again, don't be demoralized if you're getting like say 20 or 30%, because, like, frankly, I used to get a lot of that. Even I used to get a lot of like such scores just a few days before the exam as well. You have sufficient amount of time for one complete revision. Definitely, you definitely have one sufficient amount of time for one particular revision. So pick up your notes, just go through them quickly, okay, as fast as possible. Start with the easier subjects, number one. Start with your short subjects, which are comparatively a lot easier and definitely very high yield. Like in this year's INICD session, like lots of questions from SSM and other small subjects. So devote 1 to maximum 2 days for that, not more than that, because you don't have to read everything about the subject. Just be thorough with the basics. Make sure you don't miss out on the basics, please. Don't miss out on the basic questions, because if you like in the exam, if you like miss out on the basic questions, it like the risk of clustering, you know, it increases, because a lot of people will be able to do that correctly, right? So don't miss out on the basic. Make sure you revise all the basic points, and then at the end, just revise the things which you find volatile. Okay, yeah, I'm sure we all know what are the points where we currently lack. So just focus on that at the end of the day. And if possible, at the same time, do a couple of MCQs related to that. When you are more or less sure, like, about what are the big areas you are strong at, you might consider of skipping that and just focus on your wrongs. Okay, just focus on your wrongs and note down whatever mistakes you are doing. Like, if you are more of a person who notes things down, then do that. Or if you know someone who just bookmarks things, then do that, whatever fits you. So focus on your wrongs mostly in the last 30 days. And I would say max 4 to 6 hours, not more than that on a GT. Okay, because you're at this point, you're just preparing like for the main exam. So you're just finding out how many corrects you can get and not really where exactly your weaker points are. So when you're appearing for the GT, think of it as if you're giving the real exam as much as it is possible. We all know that it's not possible. We're literally on our phones and we're just, you know, randomly moving about, going to the washroom and whatnot, even texting our friends. But try to, you know, simulate the conditions as much as possible right from the start, so that, you know, it gives you the feel. So again, this before the GTs, I'm sure you should be practicing a bit of MCQ. Okay, practice a bit of MCQ before you give the GTs, because like, not everything which is in the GT, you won't be knowing everything which comes in an exam. Okay, it's not possible. It's not humanly possible. I would rather say you just know maybe max 70% of the questions, not even 65 to 70% of the questions directly. After that, there is this 15% gap, maybe 10 to 15% gap, maybe. For that, you have to work on guesswork. Okay, so that guesswork is very, very important. That guesswork is very, very important. For that, it comes along with practice. Like I said, the Q-bank, whatever source you have, just keep on practicing quality MCQ. Okay, so along with that, suppose you're giving the GT, right? So again, see the question, look at the question and look at the options. I feel like if you look at the options very, very closely, like a lot of times you'll be able to like rule them out. But I mean, this has been said a lot of times. For example, there's one particular statement where there's just a not. It does not happen, or like it does happen, it always happen. Like maybe some adjective they're adding. These adjectives are very, very important, because most of the times these adjectives, like most of the times they are wrong. Or so you're you should be able to get a bird's eye view, like just get a glance at the options, and then after that read the options very, very carefully, because you will be able to rule them out, because the questions will be framed in such a manner, because some of the questions will look, options will look obvious. So keep on doing that. Use a guess tracker. It helps, you know, it helps you to, you know, gauge how well you are guessing. I utilize my pearls mainly for those volatile topics, because the pearls are really set, you know, like that only, mainly for the volatile topics. For the volatile subjects as well, for the short subjects, definitely go for the marrow pearls. Okay, for anesthesia, for psychiatry and all, definitely go for the marrow pearls, and use the marrow pearls before the exam. I would say, like, suppose you have to finish a subject and you are not being able to do that, if you feel that time's running short, just do the pearl, because that saves you a lot of time. Because the pearls have very high yielding potential. I am on the Marrowlings group. I would say, like, almost all of you teachers, they, you know, you do respond very quick, and the responses are really, really, really thorough and to the point. So based on that, I would say, I mean, definitely there are a lot of questions which you, if you could just, you know, search on the Marrowlings group, you would find the answer, you particularly have given a lot of answers on the group. So the answers are very detailed, and it, you know, just avoids any controversy or something like that. So it's very good. It's very, you know, helpful for us to, you know, just go to the group and search the question and find the answer there. And it's that, there's no more controversy there. So thank you so much for that, and thank you for all the, you know, for all the We Are With You sessions as well. I did watch a few sessions, a couple of them. I did not watch all of them, but I did watch a few. So they were really cool. I would say the pediatrics surgery one was pretty good. It was really good. I did watch that. Okay.